We have still on the House leadership row, Act CIS Party List Representative and Appropriations Committee Chair Eric Yap. He was with Speaker Alan Cayetano in a meeting with Presidential Son and House Deputy Speaker Paulo Duterte last week. But let's start with this. In yesterday's voting, is it right you abstained?
Yes, Ma'am Karen, I abstained po kasi mas gusto ko po maging neutral dahil budget season po ngayon. So lahat po ng focus ko gusto ko po ilagay po sa budget.
Okay, but then when I interviewed you, you declared utmost support for Speaker Cayetano. So I think it's a surprise for many that when it was, do you reject, so to speak, his resignation, one would think that you would make your voice heard, cast your vote, and say, no, I don't want the speaker to resign.
Yes, Ma'am Karen, I express support to the speaker because he's now the speaker and I respect the institution po. So bilang speaker po, ginagalang ko po siya at sinusundan ko po siya. Pero pagdating po sa magkakaroon ng botohan, I will abstain po dahil ngayon po ay budget season. Bilang chairman ng appropriations, siguro ma'am ito po yung pinakatama kong gawin na huwag po makisali sa gulo ng mga speakership na issues at mag-instead mag-focus po sa budget. Kasi ma'am, kung ako rin makikisali, kawawa po ang taong bayan, kawawa ang Pilipinas. Wala pong mag-aalaga, wala pong tututok sa budget ng ating bansa.
Okay. Now, Congressman Yap, how do you describe yesterday's events?
Kahapon, nandoon ako, so nag-observe lang ako, but I talked to the appropriations team. So nag-uusap kami paano yung mga strategy na gagawin namin para umabot kami on time and at the same time, make sure po na lahat po ng budget na ipapasa namin, eh talagang kailangan po ng tao. Ito po yung makakatulong sa taong bayan.
Now, if I were to ask you, October 14 was the set date, supposedly, for Congressman Lord Velasco to take over as Speaker. Do you believe that Speaker Cayetano should honor that?
Ma'am Karen, as I've said po, no, I want to remain neutral. Kung sino man po maging Speaker, let's say, pumalit po si Congressman Velasco or magstay si Speaker Cayetano, I will respect the institution and I will follow the Speaker. At kung sakali naman tanggalin nila ako dahil naging neutral ako, I will respect their decision because they are my speaker po.
Okay. So it seems to me that whether Cayetano or Velasco is speaker, that you'll work with both, so to speak.
Yes, Ma'am Karen, because I have to stand up for our people. I have to be neutral. I have to do what I have to do because this is the budget season. And bilang appropriations chair, malaki po yung responsibility na nakaatang sa akin. At kung ako po ay mamumuliti ka pa, makikisali po sa awayan ng left and right, eh ma'am, kawawa po yung mga taong bumoto sa akin. At I will let all the Filipino people down.
Now, we have to remember that you were actually made or put in the Appropriations Committee, which is quite powerful, if not the most powerful in the lower house, by Speaker Cayetano already, because before you was Congressman Ungab, right?
Yes, Ma'am Karen.
Okay. And there are threats, or you can correct me, that I think, was it Deputy Speaker El Rey who said on the show that once Velasco sits, that you will be replaced? Have you heard
it's
this?
Okay. Yes, Ma'am Karen, it is okay with me as long as sinabi naman ng Speaker, I will obey. Kahit naman si Speaker Cayetano, anytime pwede niya sabihin na, oh, Congressman Yap, you're now out. I want this to be the new Chairman of Appropriations. I will respect that too, Ma'am Karen. Kasi ma'am, I follow the institution and the Speaker is my boss. Kumbaga, kung sino po yung maging Speaker, yung po yung susundan ko. Kahit sabihin niya, huwag ka nang pumasok, you resign, gagawin ko po yun because I respect the institution.
Okay. You've made that clear. Now I'll ask you this question. Dapat bang sundin nila si Pangulong Duterte?
Kung ako kasi, Ma'am Karen, I follow the institution, I put the people first, and then for me kasi, Ma'am Karen, iba yung sa akin, iba yung scenario ko. I'm the appropriations chair. So hindi ako pwedeng talagang sumama sa politik. Okay. Kumbaga gustuhin ko man, umampisa left or right, but I cannot. I have to be with the people. Because ma'am, budget season, I'm the chairman. If I will go, politicking with the speaker, eh kawawa man yung tao, ma'am. Walang mag-aasikaso ng budget nila and walang tao magpo-focus doon sa budget.
Okay. Congressman Nograles described yesterday's events or yesterday's stunt as a waste of taxpayers' money. The budget deliberations have been delayed by a day and a half. All right? And he said, we can't afford any more of this. Do you agree?
Actually, ma'am, we have a debate with Congressman Mike Defensor and Deputy Speaker Elray. Kinausap niya kami na ipostpone namin ng one day. One and a half days. Una, I rejected it. Then because I am pressured na matapos talaga namin yung budget because the people really needs it. This is the most important budget in the history. Because ngayon tayo may pandemic, ngayon kailangan ng tao yung tamang budget that will fit for their needs. Pero after explaining to me, within siguro mga 30 minutes din kami nag-usap, na kung yung isususpend naman natin yung deliberation sa plenary, hindi naman tayo magpapahinga, magbabakasyon. We will Zoom, we will talk to the majority, we will talk about the parochial concerns. Ibig sabihin na parochial concerns, let's say Congressman Tevez, ano yung kailangan mo sa distrito mo, yung mga tao mo? Do they need hospital, schools, bridges, or roads? So yun po yung mga pag-uusapan namin, bawat district, aalamin namin ano yung pangangailangan nila and ano yung concerns po nila for their constituent. And then after that, pag nag-proceed po kami sa plenary, eh siguro may iwasan na po yung mga questioning about parochial concerns and we will move to question yung pag-uusapan na po yung mga kailangan po ng taong bayan as a whole, as a nation.
Yeah, okay. But what did yesterday's event cost the budget?
Siguro ma'am, yung delay naman kasi ng 1.5 days, kaya namin habulin yun eh. As long as we address all the parochial concerns of the 300 congressmen. Kasi ma'am, remember, yung mga 300 congressmen, yung mga district congressmen, they love their district. For example, Mr. Duterte, Paulo Duterte, he loved very much the Davao District 1. In fact, ngayon po lang po nakita yung District 1 ng Davao na ganyan kaasensado, ganyan po gumanda yung kalsada, and ganun po karami yung tulong na naibibigay sa tao. So, pag nakikita mo yung congressman, how they love their district, you will be amazed, ma'am. Kaya ang sa akin, yung mga parochial concerns, it is valid. As long as we talk with ourselves, wag po dalhin sa media, wag po mag-away-away, pag-usapan po kung may hindi pagkakasunduan.
On that note, Congressman Eric Yap, thank you so much for always agreeing to do Head Start. I appreciate it. Thank you, sir.
Yes, Karen. Thank you po. Thank you.